The Book of Jasher Prose Form edited by Alan Lewis Silva. By Yasher Jasher. Podcast 17 of 22. Chapter 64. And Balaam, the son of Beor, was engaged at that time with Anges in battle, and when he saw that Zepho prevailed over Anges, he fled from there and went to Chittim. And Zepho and the children of Chittim received him with great honor, for Zepho knew Balaam's wisdom, and Zepho gave unto Balaam many gifts and he remained with him. And when Zepho had returned from the war, he commanded all the children of Chittim to be numbered who had gone into battle with him, and behold, not one was missing. And Zepho rejoiced at this thing, and he renewed his kingdom, and he made a feast for all his subjects. But Zepho did not remember the Lord and did not consider that the Lord had helped him in battle, and that he delivered him and his people from the hand of the king of Africa. But continued to walk in the ways of the children of Chittim and the wicked children of Esau, to serve other gods which his brethren, the children of Esau, had taught him. It is therefore said, from the wicked goes forth wickedness. And Zepho reigned over all the children of Chittim securely, but knew not the Lord who had delivered him and all his people from the hand of the king of Africa, and the troops of Africa came no more to Chittim to plunder as usual, for they knew of the power of Zepho who had smitten them all at the edge of the sword. So Anges was afraid of Zepho, the son of Eliphaz, and of the children of Chittim the rest of all the days of his life. At that time when Zepho had returned from the war, and when Zepho had seen how he prevailed over all the people of Africa and had smitten them in battle at the edge of the sword, then Zepho advised with the children of Chittim, to go to Egypt to fight against the sons of Jacob and Pharaoh king of Egypt. For Zepho heard that the mighty men of Egypt were dead and that Joseph and his brethren, the sons of Jacob, were dead, and that all their children, belonging to the children of Israel, remained in Egypt. And Zepho considered to go to fight against them and all Egypt, to avenge the cause of his brethren, the children of Esau, whom Joseph with his brethren and all Egypt had smitten in the land of Canaan when they went up to bury Jacob in Hebron. And Zepho sent messengers to Hadad, the son of Bedad, and to the king of Edom and all his brethren, the children of Esau, saying, did not you say that you would not fight against the king of Africa, for he is a member of your covenant? Behold, I fought against him and smote him and all his people. Now therefore I have resolved to fight against Egypt and the children of Jacob who are there, and I will be revenged through them for what Joseph and his brethren and ancestors did to us in the land of Canaan, when they went up to bury their father in Hebron. Now then, if you are willing to come to me to assist me in fighting against them and Egypt, then shall we avenge the cause of our brethren. And the children of Esau hearkened to the words of Zepho, and the children of Esau gathered themselves together, a very great people, and they went to assist Zepho and the children of Chittim in battle. And Zepho sent to all the children of the east and to all the children of Ishmael messengers with words like unto these, and they gathered themselves and came to the assistance of Zepho and the children of Chittim in the war upon Egypt. And all these kings, the king of Edom and the children of the east, and all the children of Ishmael, and King Zepho of Chittim, went forth and arrayed all their hosts in Hebron. And the camp was very heavy, in length extending a distance of 3 days' journey, a people numerous as the sand upon the seashore which cannot be counted. And all these kings and their hosts went down to go against all Egypt in battle, and encamped together in the valley of Pathros. And all Egypt heard the report of it, and they also gathered themselves together, all the people of the land of Egypt, and of all the cities belonging to Egypt, about 300,000 men. And the men of Egypt sent a message also to the children of Israel who were in those days in the land of Goshen, to come to them in order to go and fight against these kings. And the men of Israel assembled, and they were about 150 men, and they went into battle to assist the Egyptians. And the men of Israel and of Egypt went forth, about 300,000 men and 150 men, and they went toward these kings to battle, and they placed themselves from without the land of Goshen opposite Pathros. But the Egyptians did not trust Israel to join their camps for battle, for all the Egyptians said, perhaps the children of Israel will deliver us into the hands of the children of Esau and Ishmael, for they are their brethren. And all the Egyptians said unto the children of Israel, remain you here together with each other in your place, and we will go and fight against the children of Esau and Ishmael, and if these kings should prevail over us, then come you all together upon them and assist us. And the children of Israel did so. And of Edom Zepho of Chittim, the son of Eliphaz son of Esau, and King Hadad of Edom, the son of Bedad, and all their camps, and all the children of the east and the children of Ishmael, a people numerous as sand, encamped together in the valley of Pathros opposite Tachpanches. And Balaam, the son of Beor the Syrian, was there in the camp of Zepho, for he came with the children of Chittim for battle, and Balaam was a man highly honored in the eyes of Zepho and his men. And Zepho said unto Balaam, Try by divination for us that we may know who will prevail in the battle, we or the Egyptians. And Balaam rose up and tried the art of divination, and he was skillful in the knowledge of it, but he was confused and the work was destroyed in his hand. And he tried it again but it did not succeed, and Balaam despaired of it and left it and did not complete it, for this was from the Lord, in order to cause Zepho and his people to fall into the hands of the children of Israel, who trusted in the Lord, the God of their ancestors, in their war. And Zepho and Hadad put their forces in battle array. And all the Egyptians went alone against them, about 300,000 men, and not one man of Israel was with them. And all the Egyptians fought with these kings opposite Pathros and Tachpanches, and the battle was severe against the Egyptians. And the kings were stronger than the Egyptians in that battle, and about 180 men of Egypt fell on that day, and about 30 men of the forces of the kings, and all the men of Egypt fled from before the kings. So the children of Esau and Ishmael pursued the Egyptians, continuing to smite them unto the place where existed the camp of the children of Israel. And all the Egyptians cried unto the children of Israel, saying, Hasten to us and assist us and save us from the hands of Esau, Ishmael, and the children of Chittim. And 150 men of the children of Israel ran from their station to the camps of these kings, and the children of Israel cried unto the Lord their God to deliver them. And the Lord hearkened to Israel, and the Lord gave all the men of the kings into their hand, and the children of Israel fought against these kings, and the children of Israel smote about 4,000 of the king's men. And the Lord threw great consternation in the camp of the kings, so that fear of the children of Israel fell upon them. And all the hosts of the kings fled from before the children of Israel, and the children of Israel pursued them, continuing to smite them unto the borders of the land of Gush. And the children of Israel slew of on the road yet another 2,000 men, and of the children of Israel not one fell. And when the Egyptians saw that the children of Israel had fought with so few men against the kings, and that the battle was so very severe against them, all the Egyptians were greatly afraid of their lives on account of the strong battle, and all Egypt fled, every man hiding himself from the arrayed forces, and they hid themselves along the road, and they left the Israelites to do the fighting. And the children of Israel inflicted a terrible blow upon the king's men, and they returned after they had driven them to the border of the land of Gush. And all Israel knew what the men of Egypt had done to them, that they had fled from them in battle and left them to fight alone. So the children of Israel also acted with cunning. As the children of Israel returned from battle, they found some of the Egyptians along the road and smote them there. And whilst they slew them, they said unto them these words, Wherefore did you go from us and leave us, being a few people, to let us fight against these kings who had a great people to smite us, that you might thereby deliver your own souls? And of some that the Israelites met on the road, they the children of Israel spoke to each other, saying, Smite, smite, for he is an Ishmaelite or an Edomite, or from the children of Chittim, and they stood over him and slew him, whilst they knew he was an Egyptian. And the children of Israel did these things cunningly against the Egyptians, because they had deserted them in battle and had fled from them. And the children of Israel slew of the men of Egypt along the road in this manner, about 200 men. And all the men of Egypt saw the evil that the children of Israel had done to them. So all Egypt feared greatly the children of Israel, for they had seen their great power, and that not one man of them had fallen. So all the children of Israel returned with joy on their road to Goshen, and the rest of Egypt returned, each man to his own place. Chapter 65. And it came to pass after these things, that all the counselors of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and all the elders of Egypt assembled and came before the king and bowed down to the ground, and they sat before him. And the counselors and elders of Egypt spoke unto the king, saying, Behold, the people of the children of Israel is greater and mightier than we are, and thou knowest all the evil which they did to us on the road when we returned from battle. And thou hast also seen their strong power, for this power is unto them from their fathers, for but a few men stood up against a people numerous as the sand, and smote them at the edge of the sword, and of themselves not one has fallen, so that if they had been numerous they would then have utterly destroyed them. Now therefore, give us counsel what to do with them, so that we gradually destroy them from amongst us, lest they become too numerous for us in the land. For if the children of Israel should increase in the land, they become an obstacle to us, and if any war should happen to take place, they will join our enemy against us with their great strength and fight against us to destroy us in the land, and go away from it. So the king answered the elders of Egypt and said unto them, This is the plan conceived against Israel, from which we will not depart. Behold, in the land are Pithom and Ramses, cities unfortified against battle. It behoves you and us to start building there, and to fortify them. Now therefore, go you also and act cunningly toward them, and proclaim with a voice in Egypt and in Goshen at the command of the king, saying, All ye men of Egypt, Goshen, Pathros, and all their inhabitants. The king has commanded us to build Pithom and Ramses and fortify them for battle, who amongst you of all Egypt, of the children of Israel and of all the inhabitants of the cities, are willing to build with us, each shall have his wages given to him daily at the king's order, so go you first and do cunningly, and gather yourselves and come to Pithom and Ramses to build. And whilst you are building, cause a proclamation of this kind to be made throughout Egypt every day at the command of the king. And when some of the children of Israel shall come to build together with you, you shall give them their wages daily for a few days. And after they shall have built together with you for their daily hire, draw yourselves away from them daily, one by one in secret, and then you shall rise up and become their taskmasters and officers, and you shall leave them afterward to build without wages, and should they refuse, then force them with all your might to build. And if you do this, it will be well with us to strengthen our land against the children of Israel, for on account of the fatigue of the building and the work, the children of Israel will decrease, because you will deprive them from their wives day by day. And all the elders of Egypt heard the counsel of the king, and the counsel seemed good in their eyes and in the eyes of the servants of Pharaoh, and in the eyes of all Egypt, and they did according to the word of the king. And all the servants went away from the king, and they caused a proclamation to be made in all of Egypt, in Tachpanches and in Goshen, and in all the cities which surrounded Egypt, saying, You have seen what the children of Esau and Ishmael did to us, who came to war against us and wished to destroy us. Now therefore, the king commanded us to fortify the land, to build the cities Pithom and Ramses, and to fortify them for battle, if they should again come against us. Whosoever of you from all Egypt and from the children of Israel will come to build with us, he shall have his daily wages given by the king, as his command is unto us. And when Egypt and all the children of Israel heard all that the servants of Pharaoh had spoken, there came from the Egyptians and the children of Israel to build with the servants of Pharaoh, Pithom, and Ramses, but none of the children of Levi came with their brethren to build. And all the servants of Pharaoh and his princes came at first with deceit to build together with all the people of Israel as daily hired laborers, and they gave to Israel their daily hire at the beginning. And the servants of Pharaoh built with all the people of Israel, and were employed in that work with Israel for a month. And at the end of the month, all the servants of Pharaoh began to withdraw secretly from the people of Israel daily. And Israel went on with the work at that time, but they then received their daily hire, because some of the men of Egypt were yet carrying on the work with Israel at that time, therefore the Egyptians gave Israel their hire in those days, in order that they, the Egyptians their fellow workmen, might also take the pay for their labor. And at the end of a year and 4 months all the Egyptians had withdrawn from the children of Israel, so that the children of Israel were left alone engaged in the work. And after all the Egyptians had withdrawn from the children of Israel, they returned and became oppressors and officers over them, and some of them stood over the children of Israel as taskmasters, to receive in their stead all that they were given for the pay of their labor. And the Egyptians did in this manner to the children of Israel day by day, in order to afflict the Israelites in their work. And all the children of Israel were alone, engaged in the labor, and the Egyptians refrained from giving any pay to the children of Israel from that time forward. And when some of the men of Israel refused to work on account of the wages not being given to them, then the exactors and the servants of Pharaoh oppressed them and smote them with heavy blows, and made them return by force, to labor with their brethren. Thus did all the Egyptians unto the children of Israel all the days. And all the children of Israel were greatly afraid of the Egyptians in this matter, and all the children of Israel returned and worked alone without pay. And the children of Israel built Pithom and Ramses, and all the children of Israel did the work, some making bricks, and some building, and the children of Israel built and fortified all the land of Egypt and its walls, and the children of Israel were engaged in work for many years, until the time came when the Lord remembered them and brought them out of Egypt. But the children of Levi were not employed in the work with their brethren of Israel, from the beginning unto the day of their going forth from Egypt. For all the children of Levi knew that the Egyptians had spoken all these words with deceit to the Israelites, therefore the children of Levi refrained from approaching the work in which their brethren labored. And the Egyptians did not direct their attention to make the children of Levi work afterward, since they had not been with their brethren at the beginning, therefore the Egyptians left them alone. And the hands of the men of Egypt were directed with continued severity against the children of Israel in that work, and the Egyptians made the children of Israel work with rigor. And the Egyptians embittered the lives of the children of Israel with hard work, in making mortar and bricks, and also in all manner of work in the field. And the children of Israel called Melol the king of Egypt, Mirror king of Egypt, because in his days the Egyptians had embittered their lives with all manner of work. And all the work wherein the Egyptians made the children of Israel labor, was exacted by them with rigor, in order to afflict the children of Israel, but the more they afflicted them, the more they increased and grew, and seeing this the Egyptians were grieved because of the children of Israel. Chapter 66. At that time Hadad died, the son of King Bedad of Edom, and Samla from Mesrica, from the country of the children of the east, reigned in his place. In the 13th year of the reign of Pharaoh king of Egypt, which was the 125th year of the Israelites going down into Egypt, Samla had reigned over Edom 18 years. And when he reigned, he drew forth his hosts to go and fight against Zepho the son of Eliphaz and the children of Chittim, because they had made war against King Anges of Africa and had destroyed his whole army. But he did not engage with him, for the children of Esau prevented him, saying he was their brother. So Samla listened to the voice of the children of Esau, and turned back with all his forces to the land of Edom, and did not proceed to fight against Zepho, the son of Eliphaz. And Pharaoh king of Egypt heard this thing, saying, King Samla of Edom has resolved to fight the children of Chittim, and afterward he will come to fight against Egypt. And when the Egyptians heard this matter, they increased the labor upon the children of Israel, lest the Israelites should do unto them as they did unto them in their war against the children of Esau in the days of Hadad. So the Egyptians said unto the children of Israel, Hasten and do your work, and finish your task, and strengthen the land, lest the children of Esau your brethren should come to fight against us, for on your account will they come against us. And the children of Israel did the work of the men of Egypt day by day, and the Egyptians afflicted the children of Israel in order to lessen them in the land. But as the Egyptians increased the labor upon the children of Israel, so did the children of Israel increase and multiply, and all of Egypt was filled with the children of Israel. And in the 125th year of Israel's going down into Egypt, all the Egyptians saw that their counsel did not succeed against Israel, but that they increased and grew, and the land of Egypt and the land of Goshen were filled with the children of Israel. So all the elders of Egypt and its wise men came before the king and bowed down to him and sat before him. And all the elders of Egypt and the wise men thereof said unto the king, May the king live forever, Thou advised us the counsel against the children of Israel, and we did unto them according to the word of the king. But in proportion to the increase of the labor so do they increase and grow in the land, and behold the whole country is filled with them. Now therefore our Lord and King, the eyes of all Egypt are upon thee to give them advice with thy wisdom, by which they may prevail over Israel to destroy them, or to diminish them from the land. And the king answered them, saying, Give you counsel in this matter that we may know what to do unto them. And an officer, one of the king's counselors, whose name was Job, from Mesopotamia in the land of Uz, answered the king, saying, If it please the king, let him hear the counsel of his servant. And the king said unto him, Speak. And Job spoke before the king, the princes, and before all the elders of Egypt, saying, Behold, the counsel of the king which he advised formerly in respect to the labor of the children of Israel is very good, and you must not remove from them that labor forever. But this is the advice counseled by which you may lessen them, if it seems good to the king to afflict them. Behold, we have feared war for a long time, and we said, When Israel becomes fruitful in the land, they will drive us from the land if a war should take place. If it please the king, let a royal decree go forth, and let it be written in the laws of Egypt which shall not be revoked, that every male child born to the Israelites, his blood shall be spilled upon the ground. And by you doing this, when all the male children of Israel shall have died, the evil of their wars will cease. Let the king do so and send for all the Hebrew midwives and order them in this matter to execute it. So the thing pleased the king and the princes, and the king did according to the word of Job. And the king sent for the Hebrew midwives to be called, of which the name of one was Shephra, and the name of the other Puah. And the midwives came before the king, and stood in his presence. And the king said unto them, When you do the office of a midwife to the Hebrew women, and see them upon the stools, if it be a son, then you shall kill him, but if it be a daughter, then she shall live. But if you will not do this thing, then will I burn you up and all your houses with fire. But the midwives feared God and did not hearken to the king of Egypt nor to his words, and when the Hebrew women brought forth to the midwife son or daughter, then did the midwife do all that was necessary to the child and let it live, thus did the midwives all the days. And this thing was told to the king, and he sent and called for the midwives and he said to them, Why have you done this thing and have saved the children alive? And the midwives answered, and spoke together before the king, saying, Let not the king think that the Hebrew women are as the Egyptian women, for all the children of Israel are hale, and before the midwife comes to them they are delivered, and as for us thy handmaids, for many days no Hebrew woman has brought forth upon us, for all the Hebrew women are their own midwives, because they are hale. And Pharaoh heard their words and believed them in this matter, and the midwives went away from the king, and God dealt well with them, and the people multiplied and waxed exceedingly.